Imagine standing across from a creature 3 times stronger than you, built like a compact tank, and molded by evolution to shrug off wounds that would hospitalize you, if not kill you. Now imagine that beast is your distant cousin. Meet the Neanderthals. For over a century, they've been dismissed as slow, stupid, and extinct. Ever since their bones were unearthed in a German cave in 1856, we've told ourselves they were the dumb cavemen who couldn't keep up with us smarter humans. But guess what? The more we dig, the more we realize we got it all wrong. These weren't primitive leftovers. They were survival machines. They weren't evolutionary mistakes. They were a high-performance model of the human species. They built tools, made art, practiced healthcare, and some of them might be in your family tree. If you have ancestors from anywhere outside Africa, congratulations, you're part Neanderthal. Let's explore what made them so incredible and why their story might rewrite everything we thought we knew about what it means to be human. Forget the caveman cliches. Neanderthals didn't walk around like hunched gorillas. They were engineered for the Ice Age. Their compact, muscular builds weren't clumsy. They were optimized for conserving heat in sub-zero climates. Short limbs, thick torsos. It wasn't random. It was pure biology. According to the Smithsonian's Human Origins program, this body plan reduced heat loss dramatically. Now let's talk about those big noses. Far from being weird facial features, those massive nasal passages were natural heaters. They humidified and warmed icy air before it hit the lungs. And those large, deep-set eyes? They weren't just intense. They were tools, adapted for low-light environments in the far north. Inside, their brains were wired differently too. University of Oxford research shows Neanderthals dedicated more brain power to vision and physical control, less to social networking and imagination. Were they less smart? Number. They were just smart, differently. Want to know how absurdly tough Neanderthals were? Their skeletons read like injury reports from the X Games. Healed fractures in the skull, ribs, neck, you name it. And not just one-off injuries. These people survived damage that would flatten a modern human. We're talking close quarter hunting with beasts the size of SUVs. And somehow, they kept coming back for more. Their bones were denser. Their muscles were thicker. Put a Neanderthal in a push-up contest against a modern athlete, and the result wouldn't be close. An average Neanderthal male, about 5 feet 6 inches, 180 pounds, almost all of it muscle and bone. Modern humans? Taller, yes, but leaner, weaker. They weren't just built to avoid trauma. They were built to endure it, to take damage, heal, and keep going. For decades, we assumed Neanderthal tools were basic. Then we found birch tar. To make this glue-like substance, you have to heat birch bark in low oxygen conditions at just the right temperature. That's not an accident. That's early chemistry. According to research published in Science, this was a multi-step process that required trial, error, and memory. It's one of the earliest known examples of cumulative culture, knowledge passed down and refined through generations. And that was just the beginning. In 2024, a discovery in Gibraltar showed even more sophisticated fire pits, built with the specific purpose of tar production. This wasn't caveman guesswork. This was industrial design. Now here's where things get controversial. We like to think humans invented art, jewelry, and self-expression. But Neanderthal evidence says otherwise. Eagle talons turned into pendants. Pigment-stained seashells used as necklaces. Abstract cave art dating back over 64,000 years, long before Homo sapiens entered Europe. Sites like Cueva de los Aviones in Spain and Krapina in Croatia prove that Neanderthals had style. They weren't just surviving. They were expressing. They had symbolism, identity, culture. Here's the shocker. Neanderthals cared for each other. We've found skeletons with crippling injuries, missing limbs, severe arthritis, who lived long after they should have died. That only happens when someone's feeding you, protecting you, keeping you alive. This wasn't just survival of the fittest. It was survival through compassion. They nursed the sick, helped the injured, showed empathy. Think about that. A prehistoric species practicing long-term care. Before cities, before governments, before hospitals. Did Neanderthals talk? For years, the assumption was no. But now, it's a strong probably. They had the same hyoid bone in their throat, the one that anchors speech muscles. And their brains had Broca's area, essential for language. It wasn't English, but it may have been complex grunts, rhythms, and tones with structure and meaning. Here's the twist in the story. Neanderthals never fully vanished. When Homo sapiens met them, we didn't just fight or replace them. We bred with them. Today, up to 2% of your DNA, if you're from Europe or Asia, comes from Neanderthals. Their genes are in your hair, your skin, your immune system. They helped shape who we are. Here's the twist in the story. Neanderthals never fully vanished. When Homo sapiens met them, we didn't just fight or replace them. We bred with them. Today, up to 2% of your DNA, if you're from Europe or Asia, comes from Neanderthals. Their genes are in your hair, your skin, your immune system. They helped shape who we are. As the Ice Age slowly released its grip, the world began to change. Forests turned into plains, and animals migrated to new lands. Neanderthals, once masters of the cold, suddenly found themselves in unfamiliar territory. Food was harder to find. Seasons shifted unpredictably. But that wasn't their only problem. A new human species appeared on the scene, similar yet different. They hunted the same animals, gathered the same plants, and sought shelter in the same caves. But their tools were more refined, their social bonds stronger, their numbers growing. The Neanderthals, though intelligent and capable, were fewer in number. They lived in smaller groups, isolated across harsh landscapes. They were survivors, but not innovators. Their way of life remained the same for thousands of years. Meanwhile, these new humans adapted quickly. They painted walls, carved symbols, and perhaps most importantly, they connected. Ideas spread. In this quiet competition, Neanderthals began to vanish, not overnight, but over generations. Some may have joined the newcomers, even had children together. But the pure Neanderthal line? It faded. No one declared war. There were no armies, no treaties, no ruins of great battles. There was just silence. One species rising and one quietly stepping off the stage of history. In the end, it wasn't strength, size, or even intelligence that won. It was adaptability. And in a world that refused to stop changing, the Neanderthals simply couldn't keep up. Neanderthals weren't mistakes. They weren't monsters. And they weren't primitive. They were nature's final draft of a human who could fight mammoths, make fireproof glue, paint on cave walls, and care for the sick. So next time someone calls you a Neanderthal, take it as a compliment. Because deep in your DNA, there's a bit of Ice Age genius still roaring.